your live Super Doppler 4 HD weather forecast.
As you can see, things are pretty quiet outside on live Super Doppler 4 HD. A couple of sprinkles may be developing, or a couple of showers into the Piedmont of North Carolina, but really that's about it. Stronger thunderstorms now beginning to just about move into the Savannah area. These thunderstorms have been locally severe, where a severe thunderstorm watch does continue well to the south of us. 75 degrees was our high today, and that is about 10 degrees below the average for this time of the year. So enjoy the almost fall-like weather. It's beautiful. 63, very low this morning, a very mild low this morning, and a little over a half inch of rain officially at the JSP International Airport since midnight last night. And most of that occurred, of course, with those thunderstorms that rumbled across our area early this morning, about 4 o'clock in the morning. Sure, it probably woke up a lot of you folks. An early alarm clock went off with Mother Nature. Far from the record highs or the record lows on this date. At the Asheville Regional Airport, high 75 this afternoon, 58 the low this morning, and 0.12 of an inch of rain reported since midnight last night, and far from the record highs or the record lows. Outside right now in the Greenville area right now, plenty of sunshine, beautiful temperature, 73 degrees, a south to southeasterly wind at 9 miles per hour, humidity at about 59%. That is exactly 59%. 75 currently in Spartanburg, southeast wind at 7 miles per hour, humidity, you can slice it in half at about 50%. 70 currently in Anderson, south breeze at 9 miles per hour with partly cloudy to mostly cloudy skies. Relative humidity up there at 73%. And plenty of sunshine in Nashville right now, 74 degree temperature. North wind at 7 miles per hour, humidity currently at 34%. So very pleasant temperatures across the area. How about a 61 degree temperature currently in Boone? Well, it's 74 currently in Abbeville. Regionally, 72 in Columbia, 73 in Hilton Head, 68 degrees in Charleston. Right now, 70 in Myrtle Beach, right along the Grand Strand. Here's what it looks like regionally. You can see the thunderstorms where the severe thunderstorm watch continues, mainly right south of Interstate 16 between Macon and Savannah. Big-time thunderstorms here, and these thunderstorms are about ready to move into Savannah. And this is actually the same complex right here that's in the open waters of the Atlantic that produced our thunderstorms yesterday, overnight last night through this morning, then moved through the Midlands and to the coastline, and now it's out to sea. Another piece of energy upstream could develop late tonight. Somewhere around in this area could develop and then actually move across our area late tonight and tomorrow morning with some showers and possible thundershowers once again for us with this northwesterly flow aloft. And then the high pressure, which is going to build out in the middle part of the country, is going to move eastward, and that's going to allow our northwesterly flow to shift this way. And as the ridge builds in, we're going to dry out with a big warming trend as we get into the end of this week and into the upcoming weekend. Otherwise, around that high, we have a nice, cool, comfortable temperatures in the eastern half of the country, as you can see. 64, for about 9 o'clock tomorrow morning, 64-degree temperature in the upstate. So maybe a few showers or thundershowers late tonight, well after midnight, especially toward morning. And then a few showers or possible thundershowers possible during the day tomorrow in the upstate, high temperature 74 degrees. In the mountains, it's still unseasonably cool. Showers and thunderstorms off and on. Light and variable wind, high temperature around 69 degrees. That's it for the northwesterly flow with a chance of those showers and thundershowers. As we get into Thursday, Friday, into the upcoming weekend, warming trend as high pressure builds both at the surface and in the upper atmosphere, dries us out and warms us up in a big way. And that could continue into early next week. So we do need the rain, and most of us had some pretty good soaking rains the last couple of days.
Yeah. But nice to hear it on the roof.
Yep, tonight and tomorrow.
That's it. And too bad we didn't get to see Venus crossing.
Oh, I know.
The sun, yeah.
That was so cool.
I mean, we probably wouldn't be able to see it with our own eyes anyway.
Yeah. That's true.
You have to use the real special lens to watch it.
Exactly. Or you can put a hole in a piece of paper and go like this, and you can see the shadow on the ground.
Yeah. So too bad we couldn't see Venus cross the sun.
That's my point.
Darn it.
That's a safe way to do it.
I know. But 21:17, we'll watch it then.
There you go.
This whole conversation is way over my head.
Won't happen for another 100 years.
That's the next time it'll happen.